Well, if your child has a birthday coming up, more than likely you're going to be planning a party. So here were some tips, Diane Gotsman, and she's going to talk about what to do when you're planning a party. What's the proper etiquette when you're hosting a party or attending a party? This is something that we've talked about over the years, and
that's right.
It seems that people still don't know the rules, right?
That's right. And even though this is a children's subject, this is for the parents. Mm-hmm. You know, these tips are really for the parents because we don't know the rules sometimes, or the rules are blurred.
Okay. So let's start off. Well, first of all, when you're planning a party with your child, obviously you want your child's input. They're going to tell you, hey, I want such and such birthday, right?
But you know, so often, I can't tell you how many times moms will go off and plan the party without asking, what do you want to do? You know, what is important to you? So you might plan this elaborate carnival and all they want is cake and, you know, a action character.
Gotcha. Okay. And then remember, it's not a contest between moms.
That's right. You know, we are competitive in life, but when it comes to our kids, you know, concentrate on the party and not what the next mom is going to think about the party.
You know, what's appropriate for your child? Because we all know that every kid is different. Some kids do like the big parties.
Right.
Other kids might want just more of an intimate thing with family.
So back to thinking of the kids.
Okay.
Kids first.
Now, if you are going to have a semi-big party, get a manageable guest list.
The rule is, you know, in terms of the guest list, the rule is one guest per year, and then you can add a couple more kids in the group.
Right.
But you know, the reality is we have lots of friends and that never pans out. So if you're going to have a big party, get some help. Recruit some volunteers, ask moms to stay, you know, so make it manageable for you.
What do you do about the siblings? Because you say that, like, let's say you have a 5-year-old and what age appropriate they say, 5 kids for as many years as they are old.
Right.
What do you do about the siblings, though, that come along?
Well, hopefully the siblings aren't going to come along unless they were invited. You know, that's a big thing, you know, and I know that moms have multiple kids at home and sometimes it's hard to leave the kids someplace else, but if their name is not on the invitation, the rule is try and find some place to have them stay. Because, you know, we're thinking about, you know, as a host, we're thinking about the head count and goodie bags and how many hot dogs. And and if you invite someone and they show up with 3 or 4 extra family members, it throws the party off a little
bit. Well, and it might put pressure on the host, and they might get a little more anxiety with all these people showing up at their house.
We're already anxious as moms, you know, when we're having a birthday party and there's multiple things to attend to. So, you know, extra guests are going to throw us off a
little. And you never want a kid to feel like they're left out. And so that's another pressure that I guess is put on. Here's some more advice. Don't distribute the invitations at school unless everyone's invited.
That's right. And look at the school policy, because some schools do not allow you to distribute invitations at school.
Okay, and a couple more things. Have a plan B, because everything doesn't work out as planned, as
we all
know.
It never works out as planned.
And finally, thank you notes are not optional. And I think this is a great tip, because you need to acknowledge that somebody came to the party and that they actually, you know, went to the trouble to get your child a gift or whatever.
That's right.
And maybe get your child involved. I know with my 5-year-old, I had him sign the cards, you know, get him to learn how to write his name.
It's never too early, and even if they can't sign their names, especially if it's for family members, let them scribble all over. You write a quick little note and let them just touch it in some way, and that's really special.
All right. Good tips. Thank you, Diane. It's
Thanks
good to
so
see
much.
You. Appreciate it.